Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Parker Group Live. Today we are here with our rock star lender, Shawn Hunt of
Hello.
The Hunt team at GMH Mortgage. So thanks for joining us today, Shawn.
Thanks for having me.
We were thinking now that we're wrapping up 2018, mm-hmm. which is really hard to believe.
Yeah.
We started the year off talking about what we thought interest rates were going to mm-hmm. do this year.
Yeah.
And I know there have been a lot of changes recently, mm-hmm. and of course we can't predict the future, but mm-hmm. we were just wondering what you're seeing out there
yeah.
and what you're thinking for next year.
It's funny, the first video we did, we talked about the projection that rates were going to go up this year.
Yep.
And guess what? They did. we saw that, you know, into the second part of this year where rates were on a steady incline and we were kind of like, okay, we're at 5%, we're over 5%.
Yeah.
What's going to happen in 2019? Over the past 2 weeks, we've actually seen a decline back. To where rates were in August, September, which is a great thing, you know, because rates are back, everybody was freaking out a little bit.
Right.
Yeah.
But that's due to, you know, the stock market, you know, coming backwards a little bit. So if you're in the stock market, it's not as fun.
Right.
But that's part of it. Plus some overseas activity in the markets is affecting what we're seeing here in the States.
Yeah.
So you hear a lot about the Feds adjusting rates and the rates they lend to banks. And that's
right.
that's something they're probably going to keep increasing in December and even in January. But right now, it's not looking like that's going to affect actually home interest rates over the short term.
Okay.
Forecast for 2019 is we're still going to see a steady trend up again.
Yeah.
You know, so we'll start probably see into that low five and a quarter by first quarter, second quarter. But it's still right now, you know, we're back down in the high fours.
Mm-hmm.
So you're thinking, what difference does that make? Well,
yeah.
the difference on a $200,000 loan at 4.875 or 5.125 is about a $30 savings. So still, you know, it's about a $5,000 difference in your purchase market too.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right.
So for someone who has perfect credit,
mm-hmm.
looking to go conventional.
Mm-hmm.
I know it's changing daily. What kind of rate are they looking at right now?
Right now, you're looking in the high fours,
yeah.
you know, depending on credit score. So
mm-hmm.
credit score, are you putting down 5% or are you putting down 30%?
Mm-hmm.
That can affect, you know, the rate that you're getting. So that's something where they want to consult with their lender.
Yeah.
Really get a game plan.
Yeah.
We're seeing a lot of multiple comparisons now where they want, you know, options A, B, and C.
Mm-hmm.
You know, is it worth it to put down less money and have mortgage insurance?
Right.
What does that look like? Or to try to get 20% down?
Yeah. Now, I think there was just some recent changes with FHA. Is that right?
With conventional, the loan limit increase,
okay.
you know, was with that. We're waiting for FHA
okay.
Numbers for 2019.
Gotcha.
But with conventional guidelines, it's now up to 484, 350.
Okay.
So that what that means is you can borrow more before you have to consider what's called a jumbo loan,
mm-hmm.
which obviously has a jumbo loan guidelines could possibly be more strict.
Right.
Restricted of, you know, what that looks like or how much money you have to put down.
Yeah. And obviously, you still offer all the full suite of government products. So like with USDA.
Yes.
No money down, right?
Yeah, USDA is still probably the most popular program, especially for first-time home buyers. But it's not a first-time home buyer program.
Yeah.
You know, that can be used if you've owned 10 houses before. You just can't have multiple houses at one time.
Right, right.
But it is 100% financing, VA.
Yeah.
A lot of veterans in the area. There's also 100% financing.
Nice.
But then there's also, you know, your assistance program. So Delaware State Housing, you
right.
know, the program where you don't have to be a first-time home buyer and still get assistance,
yeah.
you know, if you have to look at something.
Yeah, so that old thought of having to have 20% down and then closing costs on top of that, that's not necessarily
good. It's funny how many people still think they have to have 20% down
yeah.
Yeah.
to buy a house. And that's great if you want to save up for that.
Absolutely.
But there are many options out there where you don't have to have that. And that's more common
yeah.
to not have that.
Absolutely.
Cool. That's great.
So if you guys have any additional questions about interest rates or loan products, let us know. Let Shawn know. He'd be happy to help you and just have that conversation with you. But the market is very strong right now. As we've discussed before, and interest rates are great. So if you're thinking about jumping in, now is a great time. But we look forward to chatting with you. Thanks again.
Thanks so much.
Happy holidays.